Hey, good morning to all of you. Yes, today we will discuss about the velocity addition theorem. Velocity addition theorem. Velocity addition theorem. Velocity addition theorem. Addition of velocities. Addition of velocities that we are supposed to discuss today. Okay. Yes, it carries 5 marks, of course. 6 or 5 marks, we are asking. Either 5 or 6 marks that we are going to ask for your final examination. Velocity addition theorem. Based on this, we are going to discuss about m is equal to m naught divided by square root of 1 minus v square by c square. That is variation of mass of a body with velocity. Another derivation. We tomorrow will take up that. Let us consider 2 frames of references. I will consider 2 frames of references like this. This is 1 frame of reference. This is another frame of reference. Okay. This is one more frame of reference. This is x dash. This is x, o dash, o. This is x, y, z. This is x dash, y dash, z dash. This is the frame s dash. This is the frame s. S dash is a frame moving with a velocity v. S dash is a frame moving with a velocity v. It is a uniform velocity. I will consider a particle here. P is a particle that will be moving here. This is moving like this along the common x-axis. Okay, these ideas first we had to learn it first. Okay, what are the 3 lines that I have covered? The 3 lines it has been covered now, let us consider. So what is that? Let us consider the frame of reference. Consider the frame of references. S and S dash having common x dash axis. Both are having a common x dash axis. S dash, let S dash be moving with a uniform velocity, that is v, with a uniform velocity v, with respect to s. Compared to s, this is moving. Initially, both are said to be at rest. This is coincided with o. O dash coincides with o. As the time is more and more, it is gone more. So I have chosen 2 coordinate axes, 2 coordinate system here, frame of references, 2 frames of references, S and S dash, where S is set to be at rest. S dash, with respect to S, it is go on moving along the common x-axis with a uniform velocity is equal to V. That's all I said. Now let us consider a particle here. Let us consider a particle P, which is moving here, okay. In the frame S dash, it is moving. With respect to S also, it is moving, okay. So now let us consider a particle is moving along the common x-axis. Let a particle be moving the common x-axis, let a particle be moving, which is the particle here? P. P is a particle. This is a particle which is moving, be moving along the common x-axis. Along the common x-axis, let a particle P be moving along the common x-axis. Now we have to measure, we are supposed to measure this particle velocity with respect to S dash, this particle velocity with respect to S. S dash is a moving frame with a constant velocity, it is moving. With a uniform velocity, S dash, it is moving. In that frame, I will consider a particle which is also moving. Not with the same velocity, it is moving with some other velocity. Now, what is its velocity? This particle velocity, what is it with respect to S dash? What is this velocity with respect to S? It's supposed to measure. Okay. The particle velocity, I will write one by one. Let the particle velocity measured by an observer in S, this frame. This particle velocity, there is a person standing here and he is going to see this particle which is moving. This particle is moving. A person who is standing in this frame and he is going to observe this and he is measuring this particle velocity. Let us consider that velocity is equal to U. U be the velocity of that particle measured by an observer in S. Similarly, I can write the particle velocity measured by an observer in S dash is equal to U dash. Hoping that you have understood. So what I have considered so far is, this a particle, P is a particle. This particle P, which is moving along the common x-axis, in frame S dash. It's the particle velocity related to S means a particle velocity, a person who is standing, an observer is standing in this frame. If he is measured, that value is equal to U. If another person who is present in S dash frame, an observer is present in S dash frame, if he is measuring this particle velocity, that particle velocity in the S dash frame is equal to U dash. Clear? Therefore, I can write U is equal to, means velocity. U is the velocity, don't forget, it is a velocity. That velocity is equal to rate of change of displacement, dx by dt. U is equal to dx by dt. And also we know that U dash is equal to dx dash divided by dt. X is the displacement in S. X is the displacement of the particle with related to S frame. X dash is the displacement of the same particle with, or I can say related to, with respect to S dash frame. This is with respect to S dash frame. This is with respect to S frame. This is a moving frame. This is at rest. Okay. Now I will going to take up inverse Lorentz transformation equation. By using the inverse Lorentz transformation equation, what we can write? By using inverse Lorentz. Inverse Lorentz transformations or transformation equation. Equations, because we are going to use x as well as t here. X is equal to how much? I want to write it. Inverse Lorentz transformation equation, already we have come across about that now. So somewhere else I have shown it even in yesterday's class. Inverse Lorentz transformation equation. It is there, I will show it here. It's here. This is inverse Lorentz transformation. Lorentz transformation equations. This is inverse Lorentz transformation equation. Okay, x as well as t, x and t. These two are inverse Lorentz. I will going to make use of inverse Lorentz transformation equations. Okay, so how we are going to write? Let it be there for the reference. I will write it here. X is equal to x dash plus vt dash divided by square root of 1 minus v square divided by c square. Correct? Okay, you can see both. X is equal to this. And t is equal to how much? T is equal to t dash plus vx dash divided by c square whole divided by square root of 1 minus v square divided by c square. Is it clear? Understood about this? X is equal to x dash plus vt dash divided by square root of 1 minus v square by c square. T is equal to t dash plus vx dash divided by c square whole divided by root of 1 minus v square by c square. Clear? Now differentiation we are supposed to do. Differentiating. This also we had to differentiate. This also we are supposed to do the differentiation. If you are doing the differentiation of this, you are going to have dx is equal to differentiation of this dx dash plus v with respect to time interval we have to do it. This one dt dash divided by square root of 1 minus v square divided by c square. Okay. So using the inverse Lorentz transformation equation, we can write like this. Similarly here, dt is equal to, this one we had to differentiate. So let us have a differentiation here. Dt dash plus, just like a differential equation we are writing, v into dx dash divided by c square whole divided by square root of 1 minus v square divided by c square. This is after differentiation we are going to get. We got dx and we got dt. Is that clear? This is by using the inverse Lorentz transformation equation. Let us differentiate this. Let us differentiate this equation also. Let us divide this divided by this. Dx divided by dt is equal to how much? Dx divided by dt is equal to, now I suppose to divide one by the other, this divided by this, dx dash plus v dt dash whole divided by square root of 1 minus v square divided by c square. This is a dt dash plus v dx dash divided by c square whole thing divided by square root of 1 minus v square divided by c square. This 1 minus v square by dc square under the square root get cancelled. Then the remaining thing that is equal to here dx dash plus v into dt dash divided by dt dash plus v into dx dash divided by c. Okay, therefore dx by dt is equal to this one divided this one numerator divided by dt dash, this one also divided by dt dash. First I will write that. Okay, dx dash plus v into dt dash plus v into dx dash divided by c square. This numerator, it has been divided by dt dash. This denominator is also divided by dt dash. Both numerator and denominator, it has been divided by dt dash. Therefore, dx by dt is equal to here dx dash divided by dt dash plus v into dt dash divided by dt dash. This one, dt dash divided by dt dash plus v divided by c square dx dash divided by dt dash. So meaning numerator separately divided by dt dash, every term in the denominator, it has been divided by dt dash. This is also divided by dt dash. This is also divided by dt dash. Therefore, value will not change. Dt dash divided by dt dash get cancelled. Here also it is getting cancelled. Right. Then remaining things I supposed to write. Whatever it is remaining. Before taking up the next concept, just to see that using the inverse Lorentz transformation equations, then afterwards we have differentiate that, then it has been divided by one by the other dx divided by dt, then numerator and denominator it has been separately divided by dt dash and dt dash, then whichever it is cancelled, or like we are going to simplify that, and remaining thing that we have written dx divided by dt. Okay, understood about this? Therefore dx by dt is equal to how much I supposed to write. Dx by dt is equal to, I will show it and I will copy this. Dx by dt is equal to dx dash by dt dash plus v. This is 1 plus v by c square. Dt dash cancel means we are going to get 1 here. Dx dash divided by dt dash. Is it clear? Same thing it has been written. Follow this. Okay. Yes. What is the next step here? Dx by dt is equal to u. Dx dash by dt dash is equal to u dash. One is u, the other one is u dash. So if this is equal to u here, we can write this one as okay, how much we are going to get? Okay, yes, how much you are going to get? Therefore here dx by dt is equal to u, dx dash divided by dt dash is equal to u dash plus v. This is 1 plus v divided by c square into dx dash divided by dt dash is equal to u dash. U dash plus v plus 1 divided by v divided by c square into u dash. This is the conserved equation that we supposed to get we got it. And this is applicable provided the particle, if it is moving along the common x-axis only. Like if they are moving in different axes, we cannot derive like this. Okay, and not only that, if you want to change the versions here now, I can write similarly. U dash is equal to how much? Because next derivation, if I want to take up, all these ideas must be required. U dash is, I want to write U dash in terms of U. Therefore, I supposed to write U. U dash, here it is, U dash is equal to U. Instead of plus sign, you are going to have minus sign here. Minus V divided by 1. In place of plus, you are going to get minus sign here. V divided by C square. In place of U dash, you are going to get, this is U in terms of U dash. This is U dash in terms of U. So both the relations we had to learn, we had to remember. And don't forget, as V is lesser than C, as V is very small compared to that of C, then you are going to get the classical mechanics. The equations, whatever we are going to get, is said to be the classical mechanic equation. Nothing else. So that means to say that if V is negligibly very small here, if V is negligibly very small here, U minus 0, this is 0. Therefore, U dash is equal to U, U dash is equal to U here. That is classical mechanics. But relativistic idea, it is different. So what is a relativistic idea concept? So whatever I spoken so far, just to explain the concept, just to see that last concept. Okay. I told you about this concept, velocity addition theorem, or addition of velocities. We are asking for 5 marks or 6 marks derivation. I have chosen 2 frames of references. S and S dash are the 2 frames of references, where S dash is a frame is go on moving along the common x-axis with a uniform velocity is equal to V. S frame is remains at rest. S dash frame, it is go on moving like this along the common x-axis with a uniform velocity. In the frame S dash, I will consider a particle P. This particle P, which is moving along the common x-axis, Now let us measure what is the particle velocity, how much is the particle velocity with related to S frame, particle velocity related to S dash frame. So the particle velocity with respect to S frame, the particle velocity measured by an observer in S frame is equal to U. The same particle velocity, another observer who is measuring in S dash frame, that will be equal to U dash. But all of us, we know about that. Velocity is equal to rate of change of displacement. Dx by dt, rate of change of displacement, is equal to velocity. Velocity is equal to rate of change of displacement. Velocity in U dash, in S dash. Velocity in S dash is U dash. Displacement in S dash is X dash. Therefore, U dash is equal to dx dash divided by dt. Okay. Therefore, by using the inverse Lorentz transformation equations, already we are aware of that inverse Lorentz transformation equations, I have written the inverse Lorentz transformation equations directly here. It is by using the inverse Lorentz transformation equations, we got the expression for x and expression for t. X in terms of x dash, t in terms of t dash. I will differentiate this and I will differentiate this separately. X becomes a dx, x dash becomes a dx dash, t becomes a dt dash. T becomes a dt, dt. Here it is, t dash becomes dt dash, x dash becomes dx dash. Okay, now I will divide this divided by this. Dx divided by dt. Dx divided by dt is this whole thing right hand side divided by this whole thing right hand side. Right hand side, and this is here, it has been divided. This 1 minus v square by c square get cancelled in the numerator and denominator. The remaining thing is dx dash dx dash plus v into dt dash divided by dt dash plus v into dx dash divided by c square. I have written again the same thing. Same thing it has been written. Now numerator divided by dt dash, denominator divided by dt dash. I will going to divide this numerator by dt dash. Denominator also it has been divided by dt dash. Therefore, dx by dt is equal to here dx dash divided by dt dash plus v dt dash divided by dt dash whole divided by dt dash divided by dt dash plus v divided by c square dx dash divided by dt. Dx dash divided by dt dash. But all of us we are aware of already u is equal to how much and u dash is equal to how much. See that u is equal to dx by dt, u dash is equal to dx dash divided by dt. Dx dash divided by dt. Is it clear? And of course the time interval here it is dt dash, because in s dash prime the time interval is changing, that is equal to dt dash. Therefore dx by dt is equal to u, dx dash divided by dt dash is equal to u dash. Substitute these ideas here. We are supposed to do the substitution for these two. Dx by dt is equal to u, dx dash divided by dt dash is equal to u dash. I will do the substitution. This is u is equal to, this is u dash plus v 1 plus v by c square dx dash divided by dt dash. Dx dash divided by dt dash is u dash. This is u in terms of u dash. Now I want to write reverse way. U dash I supposed to write. If I want to write u dash here, you will get u here. U dash if you are writing, you will get u here. But only thing is, in place of plus sign, you will get minus sign. In place of this plus sign, you are going to get minus sign. Plus replaced by minus. This plus replaced by minus. This is called by the name velocity addition theorem. Velocity addition theorem. Okay. If v is very small compared to that of c, if v is very small compared to that of c, or approximately v is taken as zero, then we are going to have here u is equal to u dash. This is classical mechanics. Whatever Newton he says, the same thing. U is equal to u dash. But this is relativistic mechanics. Okay, go through all these things. Again, if you want, I will show it. One concept. Tomorrow I will take up one more derivation. That is a little bit lengthy derivation. I have to get ready for all this.